Okay, today I've got a piece of cottonwood bark. It's 2 inches thick and it's 8 inches wide. I don't know what I'm going to do with it, but I got to clean it up before I figure that out. It'll be some sort of Santa. So I'm going to keep cleaning this up. I'm going to attack this side next, round off the back a little bit, and I'm going to leave some of the bark down here. Okay, so this is what I have so far. I've rounded off the edges like this, and I've even cleaned up in the back here. And I've kind of drawn in the brim of the cap, shoulder, another shoulder over here, and then you probably can't see it at this stage, but what I'm thinking of doing is having a tree, Christmas tree, come up and then over on this side. and then here's the other base of the tree right here. So it's almost going to be like he's hugging the tree, sort of. And that's sort of a challenge when you've got a piece like this and you want to put a Santa in there. You want to make him doing something or having some sort of visual interest. So a lot of times, as opposed to just putting a, depending on the piece of wood, instead of just putting a Santa in here, I'm going to have them in there with a Christmas tree. So I'm going to work on the shoulder over here and do the same thing on the other side a little bit, but I got to leave a little bit of room over here for the tree. Okay, and because I get this tree on this side, this is a fairly prominent line that I want to keep. So I'm going to go ahead and carve that out right now. I gotta figure out this hand over here. This arm is going to be somewhere like this. The hand right there. I might be able to, you hate to waste anything on a carving because just having a hand there is not real interesting. So I don't know, maybe I could do something in here that he's holding. Figure out something. Because I got the wood, so I might as well put something down here that's going to look interesting. This tree is going to come in here like this. Actually, I'm going to have it come a little bit lower. So these things, on the bigger pieces, they do take a little bit of time, so I'm going to be cutting in and out. But I'll show you what I've updated. Okay, so I've got the arm traced out over here, the mitten, and now I'm going to do the top of the cap and start to work on the face a little bit. Okay, so I'm looking for a little bit wider V-gouge than I usually use on the smaller carvings. And this is all pretty familiar if you've been watching these videos. Now I'm just going to carve out the eyes, or at least a space for the eyes. Start with that basic T, letter T shape. So what you're doing here is just basically taking out material to make that nose create the profile. Otherwise, he'd be a very flat-faced Santa. A little more depth. Got so many Santas to paint. It's not even funny. I'm gonna have to start shaking a leg. Turn it into a carving slacker. All I want to do is carve. Okay, that's looking pretty good. Actually, I want to keep with this. So, this stage, I'm going to create a little stop cut here and start to form the nose. Same thing over here. Oops. doing is creating that flat plane so that I can carve in the eyes. Doesn't have to be perfectly flat, but you don't want it too angled because the eyes will look funny. Okay, so I'm going to draw the eyes in with the pencil, and then I'm going to carve those out. Okay, so I got the other eye carved out. Lightly follow that line. Same thing over here, lightly. Just kind of follow that cut. Here's my dog snoring over here. They must sleep 20 hours a day. But they don't sleep at night. Okay, so I'm just going to do a little detail on those eyes. I think my talking might put him to sleep. It's looking pretty good. Get this other 45 and follow the side of the cheeks. Same thing on this side. Sometimes this cottonwood bark will do that to you. It's a little bit on the chippy side sometimes. Not a problem. We'll just go a little deeper right here. Okay, so at this stage, what I'll do is I'm going to draw in the beard a little bit and kind of get an idea of what I want the beard to do. Okay, so I've cleaned up a little bit around the cheeks, and I thought I'd work on this tree a little bit. Okay, I've got the beard defined. Now I've got to figure out, I think I want the base to be right here. I'll have a shoe here. And then I'm going to do a shoe here. Kind of like he's leaning into the tree. made that piece. That piece just has been dying to fall out since I started. There we go. So at it. I'm going to clean these up a little bit. Okay, so the next thing I'm going to do is work on this arm over here in the mitten and the shoes. And I'll kind of show you how that turns out. But I think the one shoe goes somewhere in here. The other one's going to have to be at an angle. Okay, so at this point I kind of figured out, since he's got a tree, we might as well make him holding a star so that, you know, ultimately, that's what's going to go on top of the tree. So that's what I did. I sketched out his mitten. I've got the star loosely sketched. Now I'm just working on this side over here. And I'm going to take a little material to help. Thank you. kind of see it taking shape. Next thing I'm going to do is work on this area, the mitten and that little star, and see how that turns out. Then I'll probably move into this tree and shape the limbs and try to get a little more definition in the tree. Okay, I've got the star roughly carved out. Just kind of working on that. I'll clean that up to a little higher level of detail. Now I'm just over here working on this part. Try to give that, make that mitten stand out a little bit. And I've already gone in here with the knife, created a stop cut, so I'm going to remove a little bit underneath the base of the tree, like this. This cottonwood bark really looks nice when it's unfinished, like underneath here, and it just has a little polyurethane on it, clear, or satin. It really picks up the grain, makes it look nice. Switch to that bigger gouge. Here it is. give this a little bit of a cuff, I'd say. A little bit of a fur cuff makes it stand out a little bit more. And do the same on that side. Get my 70 degree chisel, I think it is. Okay, so I think I'm going to take care of this little bit in here, take this face in a little, and then I'm going to start just kind of working on the tree a little bit and how I want that to kind of turn out. Put that like this. Lots of zigzags. And just kind of keep doing that all the way up. Just kind of work on the beard a little bit, and he's gonna be quite nice, I think, when he's done. I have to detail this a little bit. Shape this in up here. I think he's turning out pretty good. It looks like after taking this V gouge to it for the tree, and just kind of finish that up a little bit. So the next step after this is going to be following it up with a knife, just kind of enhance these cuts a little bit. Then I'm going to come in underneath it, once I take the knife, define these a little bit, and just do a little bit of undercutting. And I'll show you what that looks like. Okay, so this is what he looks like at this stage. Kind of did the undercutting in here. A little bit of cleanup left. Now I'll do the mustache, and I want to put a little bit of texture into this beard. And put a little detail on this robe, like that. Give it a look of motion. Okay. I think what I'll do is just kind of come in here like this. A little bit more detail. And I'll do this all the way around, and I'll show you what he looks like then. I think what I'm going to do is put a little detail on this cap too, a little fur. Maybe put a little bit more detail in the trees too, in this Christmas tree on the side. I think I'll come in with a tool and just kind of do something like this. Many tools out. And I'll do that all the way up, and I'll use something like this, a little bit more narrow, not as wide as that, and I'm just going to go around and chip out the brim on this. Give it a little bit of detail, probably with something like this, I guess. Just do this. And I'll do this all the way around and then come back and show you what it looks like. But I think our Santa's looking pretty good. The details make the difference though. I can see the nose. I need to kind of shape that up a little bit too on the sides. Okay, so got him looking pretty good. I think the next step is just to kind of pick out some of this little stuff in here, give them a light sand. Here's what the backside looks like. Got to clean up around there. Just all these little details that make them stand out. A little bit more detail, cleaning up to do. Give him a nice sand. I think he's actually looking pretty good. So I'll do some of that, and I'll show you what he looks like when I get him all cleaned up. Okay, so this is what it looks like when he's all done. Got him all sanded off. Lightly, very lightly sanded the beard. The rest of it I just got in these nooks and crannies and kind of cleaned them up a little bit. But I think he turned out okay. He'll look nice when he gets painted. I've got such a backlog though. Someday. Thanks for watching, folks.